Grammar 10.3, the sentence ending 는데, 는데요. The sentence ending 는데요 is an extended usage of closure connective 는데. By using 는데요, the speaker presents background information and lets the listener figure out what to do. It is used as an expression of politeness. So let's say the conversation between speaker A and B and phone conversation. 여보세요, 제니 있어요? Hello, is Jenny in? And B goes, 없는데요. She's not in. So in this case, the speaker presents background information and the listener tries to figure out, to figure out what to do. So instead of saying 없어요, if you say 없는데요, it's used as an expression of politeness. 오늘 영화 보러 가요. Let's go watch a movie today. 오늘 바쁜데요. I'm very busy today. Sorry, maybe next time. So in this case, the speaker avoids a direct rejection or negative assessment by conveying his situation implicitly. So when you have a disagreement, instead of saying 바빠요, it's better to use 바쁜데요. And conjugation-wise, it's the same thing as 는데요, the closure connective. For verb present tense, regardless of form, always you add 는데요, 먹는데요, 자는데요. For past tense, as we have reviewed in closure connective, you just conjugate past tense polar ending and then you add 는데요. 먹다, 먹었어요, 먹었는데요. 자다, 잤다, 잤는데요. For adjective, depending on adjective stem, if the adjective stem ends in a consonant, such as 좋다, and you add 은데요, 좋은데요. However, adjective stem ending with vowel like 크다, and you add 니은 and add 돼요, so 큰데요. So adjective, we need to be careful with the adjective depending on the stem, either 은데요 or 니은데요. For past tense, you always add 는데요. However, you need to conjugate polar ending past tense first and you add 는데요. So 좋았다, 좋았는데요. 컸다, 컸는데요. Let's review present tense, a verb and past tense again and then adjective. 먹다, 먹는데요. 자다, 자는데요. 먹었다, 먹었는데요. 잤다, 잤는데요. Adjective. 좋다, 좋은데요. 크다, 큰데요. 좋았다, 좋았는데요. 컸다, 컸는데요. Now, let's review example. My name is Michael. 제 이름은 마이클이에요. And you just want to say, what is your name? In that case, better to say, 제 이름은 마이클인데, 이름이 뭐예요? What is your name? So instead of 제 이름은 마이클이에요, it's better to use 내 이름은 마이클인데요, or 인데. Cindy called Linda, but a stranger guy answered the phone. Who is this? 누구세요? This is Michael, and who's this? 저 마이클인데, 누구세요? Or 마이클인데요. Is Linda there? Linda 있어요? She's not here now. What's this calling about? 지금 없는데 무슨 일이세요? 지금 없는데요? 무슨 일이세요? It's more like an indirect. But if, it's, when you say 지금 없어요, it's more like a direct. And I just want to show more example. 여기가 김 교수님 연구실이죠? Is this, Professor Kim's office. 네, 그런데요. Try to confirm it is. It's better to say 는데요. To show polite attitude toward the addressee. 지금 김 교수님 계세요? Is Professor Kim in right now? 지금 안 계시는데요. So you have some reservation because he's not in. So you just want to say 지금 안 계시는데요 instead of 안 계세요. To show more a polite attitude with a little bit of reservation. 날씨가 좋은데, to provide a background information. 날씨가 좋은데 밖에 놀러 가요. And you have a disagreeing idea, and I wouldn't want to go. But to avoid direct rejection, you can just say, 미안한데요, 약속이 있는데요. 미안해요, 약속이 있는데요. and leave a space to the other person to figure out, oh, this isn't, it's not going to make it. Now I'm going to ask more questions and try to politely reject using 는데요. Example number one, 시간 좀 있으세요? Do you have time? And you don't have time. I'm sorry, 미안한데요. 시간이 없는데요. Number two, 내일 파티에 같이 가요. Let's go to a party tomorrow with me. 미안한데요. 시험이 있는데요. That means, I'm sorry, I have exam tomorrow, which means I cannot make it. You figure out my situation. Number three, 박 교수님 지금 계세요? 지금 안 계시는데요. Which means he's not in. Number four, 오늘 시험이 어땠어요? How was the test today? And you can say, 어려웠는데요. Number five, 이 식당 음식이 맛있지요? And you try to seek agreement, and you have disagree idea. 죄송한데요, 맛이 없는데요, to avoid direct rejection. Number six, 같이 공원에 놀러 가요. 시간이 없는데요, I'm sorry, I don't have time.